welcome to another new video. In this video, I'm gonna do a review of this watercolor paper and also what I've done in this watercolor pad. Right, so this is the Canson, right? XL Aquarelle watercolor paper. It is 300 grams per meter square, has 20 sheets, made in France, and it is a cold press heavyweight paper. I got this in the A5 size, but in actual fact, the paper is slightly smaller than A5. It doesn't say here whether it's 100% cotton or it is a Kaivo quality. So regarding the paper color, it's probably in between the Bao Hong, which I have. To me, the creamiest paper, and this one, which is the Etcher Labs paper. It's in between, so I think it's quite a balanced color for people who actually don't like too creamy or don't like it too white. This is like a traditional watercolor paper color. Okay, issue about this sketchbook is that it's not exactly a sketchbook. It's actually a watercolor pad, right? So it means that there's these like spiral like metal rings at the top where you just open it up, right? And you can tear it off because there's perforated section at the top here. So all these papers come with a perforated line where you can actually tear off when you're done, and you can actually, you know, give this to people. And so that's why I say it's really quite a paper there where people can use as like a rough paper. It's not very expensive. I bought this in Art Friend Singapore in February 2021, and it costs about $760, and that is US dollars 561, and it sells for $481 on Jackson's Art. The test was done several months back. It was actually done even before I had a video on how to test your watercolor paper. So it may look a little bit different. The gist is there, right? For the pen test, I must say that it actually performs, it's quite smooth, right? And even with the thick nib, I didn't see any bleeding, right? So it didn't bleed through to the other side. There wasn't much of the feathering as well. So if you can see that there isn't any feathering at all, which is pretty awesome, even for the section where they actually use watercolor before the pen. So good for pen, good for watercolor after pen or before pen. So for watercolor techniques, you would actually notice that for the staining, for the lifting, it doesn't do so well, with the surfaces being a little bit broken. So no heavy lifting. So this paper, probably because it's not a 100% cotton paper, you can't really do a lot of abuse to this paper, right? So you can see here that especially when I try to lift out the staining paint, there is some surface disintegration. Glaze is fine. I think my glazing wasn't done so well, but the color layers didn't like lift off. I may want to repeat this, but so far, I mean, what I see is it's fine, and you can actually get edges, soft edges with it, so which is pretty nice. Color looks fine, and also it works with the ink quite well. And for the wet on wet, as you can see from the paper, right, it does warp a bit. Can you see? Like it actually does. There's some warping. But I think it's, I didn't use the ultramarine, but you can see here like the some of these texture of the paper, the cold press paper with that ultramarine paint in it. So far, I think this is quite a good paper. I mean, I think it's a good paper to use, something that you can practice watercolor techniques. But if you need it for archival purposes, if you need it to make commission drawings, then no, I don't think you should use this paper because there's no information about this archival quality. Let's go and look at what I've done with this pad of 20 pages. So for the first two pages, I actually just did like a swatch of the inks that I have. So here are the inks that I have, and I actually try out with bleach, so you see some parts being white and everything. So I have not completed this page because I actually bought more inks. All right, and then from here on I actually use it for the short front challenge. Remember recently I had a sketchbook tour right? And these are the things that I've done. I actually continued with what I have, and this was done with Forest Blue, and this is a shop in Craig Road, and it sells like food. It sells prawn noodle, if you can see. The next one is with the Shermink Tundra Violet. So for this one, I didn't really use a lot of Tundra Violet, perhaps just a little bit here, and you can see that beautiful separation. Next is the Tundra Orange. For Tundra Orange, also same thing, I didn't use much of it. If you realize I tore off my paper while removing the washi tape. So one thing I noticed is for this paper is it doesn't tolerate, like if you let it wet, you get it wet and you have your washi tape, it's gonna destroy your paper when you lift off that washi tape. So just be quite careful about it. So this one is Tundra Blue, and for all these painting I actually use both watercolor and gouache, so it works okay with these two media. This is Tundra Green. So this part, these are all like watercolor, and for some of these I actually use gouache and they work okay. This is Tundra Pink, right? The granulation, very beautiful. You can actually see this in this paper. And then after that, I moved on to using the Supervision color, the Chinese watercolor, which I will review soon, right? As you can see some shading here and there, right? And this only made with a few colors. Next is this one called Yellow Green. And I really quite like this one because I actually only use two colors, like just the green and TPO, which is the transparent pyro orange. I'm pretty quite happy with this one. Next is Cathedral Glass. It's a green color, and this is a barber shop, so I could actually make like a brown with the mixture with the orange and the pink. This is dark green, also from Supervision. And for some of these, I actually do have videos that you can watch when I actually did it live. I've also made a painting guide for people who just want to paint the shop without doing the line work. In the download, there's a digital line work file where you can print on your favorite hot press watercolor paper with a laser printer. And there's also a how-to guide where I share the reference photo, videos, links, materials used, and color mixes so that you can paint immediately. I've included in a link that's in my coffee shop, so you can go and download it. It's for free, all right? Just to let you know. This is with the lavender. Lavender is a very, very popular color. Almost every brand I know has lavender. But what's interesting about this shop is that I actually was quite happy to be able to achieve this color. I have no idea how I did it. I think it was with the ultramarine blue and also that lavender. So I really quite like this one. And I did this together with a friend on Instagram Live. So we did like go through, talking about work and paint and drawing and stuff like that together on Instagram, and it was pretty fun. Next one is this shop called the Chinese Druggies Association. It actually sells, it's called the Druggies, it sells food and everything. And the shop name is, the paint that I use is called Red Green from Supervision. This is one of the nicer color because it separates into green and red. Next is Royal Purple. This is also a very beautiful shop. It's called the Roma Bebe. It's a Peranakan shop, sells food and attire. So I don't think I do justice to the shop. So if you are in Singapore, if you can travel again, please go and visit it. It's really nice. The next color, next one is called is Crimson Purple, and it is a Cafe Sophie. And it's really very nice. I actually visited this place. I went in and had like a good breakfast and sketched from inside. And I heard from the owner that they are moving. So I may go visit it again. But I really quite like all these texture. So you could actually see the texture. This is with Cobalt Teal Blue, which looks really, really nice. And the color that I that is supposed to be featured in this painting is Crimson Purple, which is here. Right, and then next one is the Germ Brilliant from Shin Han, which is a very, it's like a napis yellow. And this is a shop, and I don't know, I might have made it a little bit dirty here. Yeah, but I really quite like how the whole thing feels, even though it looks dirty. And last but not least is this shop. It's like not exactly a shop, it's like an association. Martial Arts Association, and the color we use is White Knight's yellow. I really quite like the yellow color. And in this painting, I actually use some of these gel pens that I bought. It's quite an interesting name. It's called ILMILY. ILMILY. And I thought I would actually use it over gouache to see whether I could actually create all these colors. Because, you know, I've been using white gel pens and there are no other colors. So if I need other colors, I'm in a fix. So I went and buy this brand, and I would probably do like a review in the future. Right, so this is all I have for the tour of this sketch pad that I have. I don't intend to pull them off. Probably I'm just gonna keep it like that. So do let me know if you have tried out this paper and if you really like it. I personally like it. I think it's a nice paper to use when you are like not sure, you know, whether you're probably for people starting out in watercolors. I think this is a good paper to try out on. And once you are quite happy like using this, you may want to like move on to better paper. So gateway paper, I think. All right, so I thank you so much for watching this video, and give me a thumbs up if you like it. Remember to subscribe if you like to see similar content, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.